Good morning, good morning, good morning, and thank you for joining us today on Tenable Cyber Watch, news you can use. I'm Jirah Mickle with your cybersecurity snapshot for the week of December 12th. Today, we're talking about shift left efforts falling off, plus what CISOs earn and what stresses them out, and later, the quantum computing risk for critical infrastructure, a look into the future. Tenable Cyber Watch starts right now. Researchers are calling on companies to do a better job of educating developers about security during code reviews after their study shows shift left practices have fallen short. In a new study conducted by researchers at the University of Zurich, developers ranked a lack of security training and knowledge as their main security-related challenge. They also reported struggling with assessing the security of third-party software libraries and the security of the interaction between app code components. 10 developers were interviewed, and another 182 developers were polled online for the study. Researchers recommend that companies provide developers better security education and training. Another recommendation, motivate developers by offering incentives and recognition to encourage them to review code. And now we're talking all you've ever wanted to know about CISOs in 2022. They're questions that most cybersecurity professionals want to know about their CISOs. Which career paths do they take to become a CISO? How long do CISOs stay at their jobs? How much do CISOs earn? And what keeps a CISO up at night? Well, you can find answers to those and many more questions in the 2022 Global Chief Information Security Officer Survey from the executive search firm Heidrick & Struggles. This survey polled 327 CISOs from the US, Europe, and Asia Pacific and revealed some key findings regarding the most significant threats facing their organizations, most cited ransomware, followed by insider threats, nation-state attacks, and malware attacks. And when asked about personal risk, CISOs ranked stress at the top, followed by burnout and by higher than usual staff turnover. And well, for organizations struggling to fill IT cybersecurity jobs, there may just be a solution, and that is considering candidates without tech experience. As the shortage of IT workers remains a global problem, a new article from McKinsey & Co. says a popular suggestion is to look for non-tech candidates. Titled Overcoming the Fear Factor in Hiring Tech Talent, it's based on an analysis of anonymized online work histories of about 280,000 tech pros. The article finds that almost 3 in 5 U.S. IT managers started in non-IT roles, while 44% transitioned from IT to non-IT occupations. And a message from CISA to critical infrastructure organizations, quantum computing is coming, and therefore organizations should start preparing for its cybersecurity risk right now. CISA is advising critical infrastructure organizations to prepare now for the quantum computing threats. The threats are expected to materialize possibly around 2030, when powerful quantum computers will become available. So, what's the problem? These computers will be able to break existing public key cryptographic algorithms. This would create a global data privacy and security disaster. The US government is providing guidance to cybersecurity teams and issued a guide that stressed the importance of taking a number of action steps. Those steps include inventorying the systems and applications that use public key cryptography. You should also inventory the most critical data to be secured long term. For more information, check out our cybersecurity snapshot linked in our video description. And that rounds up our cybersecurity snapshot for the week of December 12th. For more insights and details from the snapshot, you can visit us online at tenable.com. See you all next week for more cyber news you can use. I'm Jirah Mickle. Thank you for tuning in. And from all of us here at Tenable, have a lovely day.